Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope and trust that everybody's doing well and dandy. So today is the final part of this whole Zombie in the Park project that I'm working on, and I'm super excited. But the different thing is the weather is very, very cold. So instead of me doing my makeup there in the park, again, I'm gonna do it from home and then leave and then do our new model today. So today I'm gonna be doing a guy. I'm gonna try to enjoy a zombie and then, you know, all that and all that. So basically I'm just gonna get ready now, and I decide to just do it at home, film it, and talk to you, I guess, what I'm doing. Maybe, maybe not, I'm not too sure. But for kill time, I probably might just fast forward, you know, some parts. So what I'm doing now is just sticking on my brows and any part that I think that I need to protect in terms of hair. I don't have anything on my face. So I go around doing that, let that dry, let that sit. At that point in time, I'm going to take a bucket brush. And then I'm gonna jump into some eyeshadow. So I'm gonna be using this palette today. And I'm gonna jump into this black. And what I'm gonna do, I'm just basically going to outline my lips. These are the very first steps that I did. Then I'm gonna outline how y'all doing though? How's the season treating you? So now I have where my outline is going to be. And I do have blue contacts. I'm just gonna cover them one more time. I'm gonna do something really similar to what I did the last time, and I'm going to put the liquid latex all around here, 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 here. So that's what I'm gonna do. Liquid latex, you guys should know it. So this is the liquid latex that I'm gonna be using today. Cut and swirl, and then we'll just finish it as we go. So I use one of these old makeup brushes to go into my liquid latex. Just makes the work a little bit more easier. Go in, and we're just gonna start layering this down. You just want to put down a thin layer that's going to be reminiscent of skin, and it's going to be distress. You'll see how I do that in a bit. So I'm just going to do that. Let that set for a little. you're basically going to cover everywhere other than the parts that I just faded a little ago. We're just going to add an extra layer of skin, and it's going to pretend like it's, well, it's going to mimic the skin and also act as a distress skin. Now with this section, I'm going to start laying down some coffee flags. So at this point in the race, we're going to start to film some cut and slap. This is where the fun begins. So what we want to do is build on top of that throw bone. So with this part, I'm going to speed up. Now we are going to fill in, just shade in. So right now the liquid latex is kind of dry and I'm starting to make holes so that I can fill in and fill in all of the spots that I will need to still in, basically, so that's what I'm doing now. So I'm making small pockets. Just ripping everything. And no, people, it doesn't hurt at all. And I'm just filling in that with black, like so. Just filling it in. What we're gonna do now, we're going to jump into some loose powder. And we're just basically going to, just basically gonna go over the white. Just so that we can get like a skin like. Then we're going to jump in to some glue, like so. So as that do what do, we're going to jump into some brown and do some shading. Just to add some texture to everything. So we want to make it white at certain places, but dark in certain places as well. Okay. I messed up this whole brush. Another one fights the dust. So basically just adding some more distress. Now we're gonna jump into some blood. So I use a lot of different types of blood. To be honest with you, this one I got from the dollar store, but I'll show you what this one does that I love. This one I will just spray on like that. And it also gives me that pinkish. It also gave me that pinkish stat that I'm looking for. I'm gonna jump in with this one. This is from Bed Night. Okay, basically, I'm gonna just dump this blood all over it, and I'm just gonna hug it. And yes, it can get dirty, but that's a part of the game. And there you have it, ladies and gents. This is your zombie one-on-one tutorial. And basically what I'm going to do now is just fine-tune it. When I say fine-tune it, just a little bit more shading if necessary. Cover some of that white. But I want it to still stay like that so it can be authentic and still badass, basically. So, we're done. Bye, remember to subscribe, hit the bell to be notified, and check out my next video. Comment into what you do. I'm out.